position of tool. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Metal 5.
Okay. This is for the segmented position 2, 3, and 4, and then metal 5.
We only start and we always finish with the proper bit. Okay?
We only start and we only finish with it.
Our goal is to knock the beads down on 1 and 2, and then we need to flatten them all out 3 and 4. Okay? There are valleys that we can't get out of position 4, we need to not run polishers. We're just going to put lines right in there, and you guys are going to have to hang them out anyway. So when we start, we're typically going to dry. And then we always start with the correct position, we start and finish with it. So when we start, go in, we're going to tweak a little bit of pressure, like right with a pin that doesn't work very well. So we want to just run it up off this blade that it kind of develops as it's running. When it's bronze, it's okay, that's normal. When it's black, like that one, that's bad. That's wrong. Okay? So we want to see what's underneath. We want to see our peaks in our valley. We need to knock that blade off first. So, go in and sweep. Constant motion, don't hold it one place. So, dark spots are our valves. The shiny are our beads. So we're going to try to knock these down to get closer to those. And what will happen is as you're addressing it, you'll see them start to spread out. Like I said, position 1 and 2, we're not trying to get it completely perfectly spread out. We're just trying to even it out a little bit. As soon as you, even if you do get them all out, as soon as you run the first piece, you'll get them back. So don't waste a whole bunch of time. And we don't want to reshape this piece. So then we're going to have to reset it up, which we don't want to do.
Okay.
So now that I see what I'm working with, I got somewhere, I'm going to push a little harder. If you keep these things in a bucket of water, when you're not using them, they won't dust up like this. Clean off so I can see what I'm doing and see what kind of progress I'm making. So yeah, to the point where I don't seem like I'm making any progress, I'm just not. I'm not really getting any further with it. There are some lines in it still. They've spread out. So that's good to stop there. When we're done, we have to spread off very well. So if we don't, what'll happen is you'll scorch the first 3 or 4 inches of stone if you don't get that cleaned off.
Thank you.
this and turn it black.
And
well, the whole thing, that's black.
Yeah.
Or if you go look at the position four back there, which kind of just a bronze or copper color, it's black. That's not good. That means something is wrong. Either a parameter's wrong, or it's hitting way too hard or something. Okay? Now, every single one of your positions even likes it, so I'm not exactly sure. So this is not normal. It's not what it's supposed to look like.
Supposed to be bronze.
Supposed to be bronze.
Start with our position two. And again, I just want to knock that glaze off. That constant sweeping, little bit of pressure. Okay, now that it's knocked off, now we can see shiny here, and we're all, we got some valleys right here in the middle. So, since there are some fairly decent lines in it, we're going to drop back toward position one to try to even them out a little bit. Lines are almost completely gone now. So that's good. I've got far enough within. So just remember, we'll start and we'll finish with the proper line. So we'll work our way back up to the right one. Position 3 is the white one. Light pressure, just knocking that glaze off. Really any significant lines in this one. Not like they were in the first position. We don't necessarily need to drop all the way back to this. We can drop just one if we need to. pretty good, and we just need to finish with Provolone. Now, there's been times where I'm dressing a set that's just shot, and even on a position four, I will drop all the way back to this one to get the lines out, and then work my way back up. There's no lines at all now. Hose up really well.
I just treated it like a polisher.
The light brown one is the final. For, well, position four anyways. Again, light pressure, sweeping, just want to knock the blades off. They've got a little bit of lines. Now, they're just kind of dark there and a little bit there. So, I'm going to drop back to my position two. Lines are gone, work your way back up. Always finish with the proper tool. Hose it off really well when we're done. Okay. It can be very difficult to correct or fix if you need to, okay? Now I have, like I said, dropped all the way back to my position one and worked my way back up to get out of a scorched spot or something that's happened to it. Now this one you should do constantly wet. The other ones you can kind of get away dry. This, anything that's considered a polisher, this is considered a polisher. It needs to be done wet, or else it'll short it. Now, not soaking wet, just damp. Again, just the constant up and down sweep. We can see where the focus is. So, I'm going to drop down just one, just to see if I can get it out.
This is once a week.
About every 10 kitchens or so.
Every what?
10 kitchens, 500 feet, however you can track it. Now, the more often you do it, the less work it is.
Made a big difference.
Yeah. Still a few ones right in the middle though.
Yeah.
That's right where my lines are, but stone as well.
Really?
Yeah. I'll drop back.
This thing oscillates as well.
Yeah.
So I don't know why it's getting lines like that.
Because that's where the focus is of it. So that's where the, not really error, it's just kind of maybe has a little bubble in the profile there. So they're a little, if you look at all the other ones, it had that same wear in every single tool.
Yeah.
It just, so that's why it's important to keep your super Z dressed and calibrated, because all the lines transition from the previous step.
Yeah.
So it'll go from the super Z to just 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way into polisher. That's why if you do nothing else, you dress and calibrate the super Z.
Which I have never done.
More pressure. Okay. Now I applied more pressure to it, but no matter what, even though our focus, our issue is in the middle, we still have to work the whole tool. Correct. We want to keep it square. So. So I'm done with that one. I just work my way back up. The more often you do this, the less likely you'll get those little apple core dog ear looking things. Okay, finish it up with the proper bit. Like always, when we're done, you hose it up. You see that?
Yeah,
and we're done.
Better.